My name's Natalie Thatcher and I'm a toxicologist. I work here at EFSA and today I'm going to talk about chemical contaminants in food. So why are chemicals in our food? Well, all foods and living matter, including our own bodies, are made up of chemicals. The nutrients in our food comprise carbohydrates, protein, fat and fibre, and a whole host of other elements. These compounds together give us a balanced diet and the pleasurable eating experience that we all enjoy. So how is food contaminated? Food can be contaminated at any stage in the food chain. Contamination can occur in the naturally occurring product. It can be introduced by farming methods or on an industrial scale during processing. Contamination can also be introduced during the distribution of our food for sales, or it can be introduced on the plate when the food is ready for consumption. This can be in our own home or in restaurants and bars where food is served. So what are contaminants? Contaminants are substances, compounds, or mixtures of compounds with toxicological properties. This means that they can cause adverse health effects in either humans or animals. We as scientists tend to think of contaminants as falling into two main categories: the naturally occurring contaminants or the man-made contaminants. If we look first of all at the naturally occurring contaminants and we think about plants, a good example here is green leafy vegetables, which produce nitrates, and too many nitrates can have adverse effects in either humans or animals. Fungi also produce toxins. The natural toxins of fungi are called mycotoxins, and they contaminate mainly crops such as cereals. Looking at the man-made contaminants, we start by looking at residues. Residues can be such things as the residues of pesticides left on crops from spraying, or those from veterinary medicines used to treat animals when the farmers are raising them. Also, the residues of food contact materials can migrate into our food products. The unwanted byproducts of processing. A good example here is acrylamide, which is formed in starchy foods when they're cooked at high temperatures. This process, of course, occurs both in the home and in the industrial process. Pollutants, as a result of man's activity, are in the environment, in soil, water, and in the atmosphere, and can contaminate our food. Such pollutants as dioxins and brominated flame retardants tend to accumulate in the fat of animals and in fish such as oily fish. We also have metals. Metals, of course, are naturally occurring but tend to enter into our foods due to the activities of man, such as car exhausts or industrial smoke contaminating the atmosphere. So what is the role of science? Well, we as scientists weigh up all the evidence and try to balance the safety and the health benefits for the consumer. So for example, we are aware that oily fish could be contaminated, but also that it's a very important part of a healthy, balanced diet.